Seamounts' Choral Fantasy, there's a line that is flowers which eternally bloom. So we're thinking he was referring to these corals. They look kind of like flowers, and they're eternally blooming here in the deep sea. Has a responsibility to monitor and manage deep-sea coral and sponge communities within U.S. waters. But it's also important to explore these communities outside our waters, in the areas called high seas.
By using the high-resolution seafloor mapping data, we prospect almost for these high-density communities, because now we're getting a pretty good feel of what type of features they like to live on. So we look for the steep ridges, steep flanks, steep slopes, cones.
So the features that John was just talking about are important to accelerating currents. And more current means there's more food coming to our corals and sponges, and more food means happy corals and sponges. They'll grow bigger, stronger, healthier. So this coral is taller than our ROV. That's pretty impressive. Because the ROV is way taller than me. Large branching corals like this make great habitat for smaller invertebrates. So I'm seeing a number of anemones, brittle stars, two carnivorous sea stars.
Sea spider?
That is a sea spider, and it looks to be feeding on the sea anemone.
On top of the coral.
An interesting way to think about the corals, you know, there's very little food down here in the deep sea, and you have these particles that are kind of drifting in the water. And things like the sponges and the corals are kind of like giant nets that are put out there and are capturing these very small particles. And so you can think of them as kind of aggregating or concentrating what little food there is in the water column. So then it becomes, you know, very attractive for predators to feed on because there's a concentrated source of food.
Just as a forest has more ecological value and harbors more species than an individual tree does, that's the same way that these aggregations of corals or sponges act as hotspots of biological diversity in the deep sea. And if undisturbed, many of these can create habitats that can persist for hundreds and even thousands of years.
Check out the base on the hemicorallium. It is massive. That base only grows a millimeter or less per year. So you're seeing something that almost 8 inches across. That's well over 200 years old right there. They grow very slowly, and if someone were to come and harvest them, recovery of this community would take a very long time.
Everybody else watching should realize how lucky we are to see this huge density, this really high density of corals, because this is not a common sight. As far as I know, we're talking, you know, on the order of 20 or so known communities like this.
This area, the Musicians Seamounts, probably has the most high density communities of any area that we've been in the last 3 years. I'm just astonished. Every single dive is coming up with communities that are different.
And it's our responsibility as people, and also as people who work with NOAA, to monitor and manage these deep coral habitats. So whether it's our waters or the high seas, it's important to study all parts of the oceans, since the ocean knows no boundaries.